Alhamdulillah, wa salatu wa salam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam amma ba'd. Ahabata fillah, from the characteristics of the people of Iman, Ahl Iman, is that they make tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so you and I need this. We need to embrace this important attribute that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves. And it gives us all hope for the many sins that we do. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala says in Kitab al-Kareem, إِنَّمَا تَوْبَةُ عَلَى اللَّهِ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لِلَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ السُّوءَ بِجَهَالَةٍ ثُمَّ يَتُوبُونَ مِنْ قَرِيبٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Kitab al-Kareem, Allah accepts only the repentance of those who do evil in ignorance and foolishness and repent soon thereafter. So one of the characteristics of Ahli Iman is that they make tawbah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made tawbah more than 100 times a day. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to make istighfar constantly. Astaghfirullah wa atubu ilayh. So this is the sifat. This is a sifa from the people of Iman. And we want to have this sifa. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Kitab al-Kareem, letting us know that what we need to do when we do sins is that we need to make tawbah and we need to come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we need to follow it up with righteousness, with a good deed. Qala subhanahu, illa man taba wa amana wa amala amalan salih fa ulaika yubaddilu Allahu sayyatihim hasanat. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala says in Kitab al-Kareem, except those who repent and believe correctly, they aminu. They believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they believe in Tawheed al-Rububiyyah, Tawheed al-Uluhiyyah, Tawheed al-Asma'i wa Sifat. They believe in the six pillars of Iman. They don't come up with newly invented matters in the religion. They accept the Sunnah and embrace the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Except those who repent and believe correctly and do righteous deeds, Allah will change their sins into good deeds. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala bless us to follow up our evil with something good. So do everything possible. If you do a sin, follow it up with rakatain. Make wudu and follow it up with rakatain. Rakatain, you know, two units of prayer. If you do a sin, follow it up with some sadaqah. Do some charity. If you do a sin, follow it up by giving salams to someone or giving doing some small kindnesses, loaning someone something, giving someone something, smiling at someone, do something good. Remind your brothers and sisters with some da'wah ila Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if you do a sin. Do anything and everything to get some of those good deeds that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala loves. And we know that ibadah, there's various ways of ibadah, various ways to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by following up your sins. Allah, Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah mentions about ibadah. He said, al-ibadah ism jami' li kullu ma yuhibbuhu Allah wa yardah min a'mal al-zahir wa batin. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah rahmatullahi alayhi rahmatin wasi'ah, he said, al-ibadah, worship, it's everything that Allah loves and is pleased with, from those things that are done intrinsically, meaning in the heart, and outwardly, those things, whether that be the tongues or the limbs, which all comprise of Iman. So it's important, Ahabata Billah, to do your best to follow up sins with righteous deeds. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.